In this video, you'll learn how to use the complex record mapper in InterSystems IRIS to process incoming files that contain complex and nested records. The complex record mapper works by breaking down an incoming flat file into the records and sequences of records that compose it. It then assembles these records into a single message object with all nested data as object properties. This process allows you to create complex objects from a unique flat file structure and then process that data in your interoperability production. The simple record mapper allows you to take fixed width or delimited files, such as comma-separated lists, and convert them into production messages. However, the simple record mapper can only import records of a single type. It cannot take in incoming records made up of nested fields, such as a list of employees alongside an address. This is where the complex record mapper comes in. The complex record mapper works by combining simple record maps and building a nested message object out of those records. Here are the general steps for creating a complex record map. Create a record map for each nested record in your delimited file. Create a complex record map built using those classes. Add the complex record map to your production. Now let's see these steps in action in a specific scenario. Monica is an interface engineer for a shipping company. She receives daily reports from warehouses across the country that keep track of the orders they have fulfilled. She needs to bring this incoming data into her production so that she can send messages to the downstream applications such as the point of sale system, the online store, and the fleet tracking application. The data enters the production as a flat file delimited by semicolons. Each record type is identified with leading data followed by a vertical bar. In Monica's file, the first row is a header row indicating the warehouse, or WRH, followed by ID, region, and the date of the report. This report is made up of orders which themselves are comprised of items and addresses. An order can have one or more items, but only one address. Next is the list of orders, each of which has one or more items and an order address. The first step is to create a record map for each record type included in the report. Monica will chart warehouse, order, item, and address. In the management portal, Monica navigates to Home, Interoperability, Build, Record Maps, and clicks New. She enters Warehouses as the package and Warehouse as the class name. She can then select a sample file of that record type to test that she has configured the record mapper correctly. In order for this record map to be used by a complex record mapper, leading data needs to be filled in. This tells the record mapper how to identify the correct segments of the message. Monica enters WRH vertical bar so that the record map will interpret any field beginning with this prefix in a complex record map as a warehouse record. Next, Monica chooses the record terminator, which in this case is LF, and then checks allow complex record mapping. She will add a semicolon as a separator and then add any necessary fields. Monica includes ID, region, and date. Then she clicks generate to create the classes. The next step is to create any additional records needed based on the data. Monica creates the order record mapper, making sure to add ORD in the leading data field. She then clicks allow complex record mapping. The fields for this record are date, total price, and shipping type. Next, Monica will create the items record. She enters ITM for leading data, enables complex record mapping, and enters ID, name, quantity, and price for the fields. Last, she creates the address class using the same steps. For the fields, she adds street, city, state, and zip code. Now that Monica has created each record map, she can create the complex record map that will combine them. She navigates to Home, Interoperability, Build, Complex Record Maps, and clicks New. Still in the Warehouses package, Monica names this complex record map Warehouse Report. Monica selects the header field and names it Warehouse, because each incoming message can only come from one warehouse at a time. Then she assigns the warehouses.warehouse record map to it. Returning to the document structure, remember that the warehouse report lists orders, which themselves are comprised of items and an address. An order can have one or more items, but only one address. In the complex record map builder, Monica will add a sequence called orders, which she makes repeating. Within this sequence, she uses the green plus button to add the order, selecting warehouses.order as the record map. Then she adds an item record using the warehouse.item record she created earlier, and makes this record repeating. Last, she adds an address record and selects warehouses.address as its record map. Monica clicks generate to compile all of the code for these classes. Now, Monica will add these complex record maps to her production. She starts by creating a business operation using the complex batch file operation class shown here. She names it recordOut and then specifies the output directory to which the operation will write. She enters warehouses.warehouseReport as the complex map. This tells the business operation to use the complex record map that Monica created to map the warehouse report object back to a flat file, and then write that file in the out directory. Finally, Monica configures the business service to take in the warehouse report file. She creates a business service using the complex batch file service class shown here and calls it recordIn, then clicks enabled. She specifies an input directory, adds warehouses.warehouseReport as the complex map, and adds the recordOut in the target config names. This tells the business service to look in the selected file path for the warehouse reports, parse them into the complex record map, convert them into an object, and finally send them to the record map operation. Typically, the business service would send this message to a business process that could process and route the information to the intended operations. For now, Monica is just testing out her complex record mapper, so she will send it directly to the recordOut operation. Monica tests her production by dragging a warehouse report into the in file. She then navigates to the message viewer, selects the message, and clicks View Contents. This confirms that the flat file structure has successfully been converted to a message object with serial properties. In this video, you learned how to use the complex record mapper to import nested or multiple field type messages into an InterSystems IRIS production. For more information on this topic, visit the InterSystems documentation website.